tenured graduate student from MIT, and today I'll be talking to you guys about the effect of putting Mentos into Coke. Hey, so today we're going to demonstrate the effect of dropping Mentos into Diet Coke and regular Coke. We're going to observe the difference in the height of the geysers. Now we're each going to drop 7 Mentos into our respective bottles. 3, 2, 1. So, first thing you guys all know is that pop is fizzy. And what causes that fizz? It's a bunch of CO2 that is put into the liquid. CO2 is this molecule right here. It's one carbon connected to 2 oxygens. Whenever they make carbonated beverages, they put a bunch of CO2 into the liquid until it hits a state that we call supercritical. And at that point, no more CO2 is able to be absorbed into the liquid, and it's kind of in a fine balance between the CO2 in its liquid state, which is what we have here, and the CO2 in its gaseous state. So the process of CO2 going from in the liquid to the gas is called nucleation. And essentially, this just means it's a phase change. But a lot of things have to happen in order for this to be possible. If you're just opening a bottle of pop, what has to happen is you have your initial CO2 bubbles come out of solution and into the gaseous form and bubble up. And in order for more CO2 to go from the liquid phase to the gaseous phase, it needs to bump into something essentially. Whether that's the side of the bottle or other CO2 bubbles, either will work. And what happens whenever you dropped Mentos into Coke, the Mentos act as a catalyst in this case. And what that means is that they act as a substance that makes this reaction happen easier. The Mento, as our catalyst, allows the CO2 to bump into it, and then essentially you have a bunch of CO2 going through this reaction really, really fast. And when this happens, as the gas all bubbles up from the bottom of the bottle, you have a lot of liquid displaced, and that's what gives you your characteristic Coke and Mentos fountain. We each have 4 Mentos placed on a nail that has gone through the cap of the Coke bottle. So whenever we put the cap on the Coke, then we'll pull out our nail and all the Mentos will fall in at once. And again, we'll observe the height of the 2 geysers. Even though it may look like a smooth round candy when you look close, if you zoom into the surface, it looks something like this. It's very rocky, full of ridges, very porous, as we would say. And so this gives it a greater surface area. And the greater surface area is what allows this CO2 liquid to gas reaction to happen even faster. This has to do with the ingredients in the Coke. So as I said before, this process of going from a liquid to a gas is all about nucleation. The absorbed CO2 needs to have something to bump into to make it do this transition from liquid to gas. And in the Diet Coke, there are more chemicals in it, and so it has more things for it to bump into, which allows this reaction to happen faster.